Hello dear learners, welcome to EPG Paathshala. I am Professor Chhaya Goyal from Center of Advanced Study in Education, MSU, Vadodara, Gujarat, India. Today we will focus on sustainable development of the learners without eye vision, the case of Dharmesh. It is under the course Perspectives, Issues and Research in Teacher Education. Let us delineate the objectives first. After going through this module, the learners will be able to identify the profile of the persons with visual challenges, employ various ways for sustainable development of the learners without eye vision, realize inclusive education for visually handicapped, exercise measures for the placement of educated visually handicapped in teaching. This module presents the case of Dharmesh, a dedicated educationist without eye vision. It presents that how he has successfully completed MA in English Literature and MET despite visual challenge, how he could sustain the studies and with social and technological support. The factors impeding his development have also been presented along with his plight of overpowering those factors. His emerging profile as a healthy personality, a dynamic, balanced person with self-support, parent support, peer support, some school support, a little state support. Though he has been employing technology, JAWS, open book software, mobile facilitated talkback and Braille, but he has not yet been in a position to employ the latest technological devices. He has successfully completed his education, but in terms of employment, the service sector at large has failed to seek his academic services. Technology has not yet been in a position to liberate him of the dependence on writers, which has been a limiting factor in his life. As his teachers, we have been feeling a lot for him, but failed to act for him in providing teaching learning material in the accessible e-form through latest available compatible technological devices. Now let us focus on the case of Dharmesh. Dharmesh Solanki, born on 31st January 1984 in Gujarat, India, has completed MA in English Literature and MED from the Maharaja Sayaji Rao University of Baroda, Gujarat, India. He has been the MSU student both at MA and MED levels. During these programs, he was found to be a very dedicated student, always keen on learning despite lack of eye vision, always insisting on e-learning material, which could be utilized by him through packages like JAWS, Job Access with Speech. The teachers were always keen on providing him with e-learning material corresponding to various programs and courses. Also, his parents would read the text from the learning resources over late nights so that he could be abreast with the course contents regularly. After completing his B.Ed, when he tried his candidature for position of English language teacher with the parent institution, his case was rejected under the pretext that being without eye vision, he would not be in a position to conduct the various activities which the school demands, particularly teaching and evaluation. It is surprising and shocking to learn that how soullessly we disown our own quality product even when there is a national ethos of special education, integrated education and inclusive education. Not disheartened, this daring graduate tried for vertical mobility for MED with specialization in teacher education, joyfully, fully and painstakingly. Then he tried for placement in school education and teacher education, particularly in the corporate private sector, where again this sector failed to induct him as a teaching professional. Then to sustain life and living, he joined a call center at Ahmedabad, Gujarat, India as consumer care executive. CCE, more than 1 year and daily from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. with a salary of Rs. 4,750 per month. Since the year 2015, he has been serving as assistant professor in a government B.Ed. college, Kutch, Surat, Gujarat, India, on contractual basis with a consolidated salary of Rs. 25,000 per month. Which are the most impeding factors in his life? Reading disability without eye vision has been found to be the most impeding factor in the life of this dedicated scholar. Writer's availability from time to time has been found to be another limiting factor in his life. However, the support from the peers, teachers and parents and family and community members helped a lot to move ahead. There was full financial and emotional support from home. Technological support. During his studies and professional entourage, Dharmesh has got some technical assistance from the following. Facility with the JAWS. He learned JAWS with Tirath at Tarsali very satisfactorily with nominal fees because Tirath has been providing support to the visually impaired with service motive. JAWS convert the e-text into audio from which can be accessed by the visually challenged. Open book software. Another software package which he has been found at ease with is open book software because here the contents in the hard copy are scanned by the optical character reader OCR which can be read by the OBS, converting it from the text to the audio stimuli. TalkBack. Dharmesh has also been working with another software namely TalkBack, which is a screen reading software inbuilt in the mobiles. The syntax is as follows. Setting, accessibility, TalkBack, click, install. E-Braille. He has been using Braille for the last 12 years, but there is a question of accessibility with respect to the software converting and printing the text into the Braille form. Moreover, it is not economically viable because 500 pages of hard text are converted into 3000 pages of the Braille text. Life satisfaction. Dharmesh is a man of literature. Every bit of his text has its own testimony. He observes decency, decorum, and discipline in every act of life. He is a humane and dedicated personality who has been very gracefully struggling with eye vision, with a mental kick and motor muscle momentum to move dynamically in every facet of life, personal, social, or workplace. His students are all satisfied with his scholarship, simple living, and high thinking. He is deeply rooted into the Indian culture. Dharmesh has a very sound family background. His father has been the administrative staff of the MSU. Parents are fully caring. Now he is looking for a life partner who has to be understanding and without a visual handicap. He does not aspire for a partner with lots of degrees, but likes to seek happiness with the humanistic grace and native culture. He is of the view that he would never disappoint his life partner on any foray, rather than try to seek suitable appointments for her. He is in quest of both emotional satisfaction along with professional satisfaction. He is a hopeful of a meaningful, healthy and resonating life. Assistive devices for the sustainable development of the visually challenged and low vision students. Assistive technology may be organized into a system of low tech and high tech tools and strategies that match a person's needs, abilities and tasks. Learners or teachers, parents pick and choose from the system the appropriate tools for the situation. Low technological devices. These refer to the unsophisticated devices and largely non-electronic devices such as hearing aids, speech trainers, braille paper and styli, tape recorders and magnifying reading glasses, hard copies of notes provided by the instructor or other student, outlines double spaced with keywords provided by the teacher or note taker, printed materials double spaced and with large print calculators with voice synthesizer and books on tape. High technological devices. These devices involve the use of sophisticated communication and environmental control systems that are electronically based. Here, the focus is on increasing variety of methods of adapting the computer through the use of special needs peripherals and or software such as laptop computer for note-taking, electronic spelling masters or dictionary with voice output, word prediction software, outline software, reading and scanning software, and voice recognition software. Let us discuss about a few of the assistive software technology devices which can be used by the visually impaired or low eye vision people. Language, software for visually impaired. The Indian Institute of Technology, IIT Chennai, has developed Braille software as well as language software which enables a visually impaired person to access computers for Braille as well as language outputs in all the Indian languages. The Vidya Vraksh Training Center for the Disabled, a Chennai-based NGO, is imparting training to visually impaired persons in the use of software. It is also providing the software completely free of cost to the users and the institutions. It has also developed a system of keyboard mapping and operations in Indian languages and instructional manual for use of the special version of the ITI multilingual software. Screen readers. These are used to verbalize or speak everything on the screen, including text, graphics, control buttons, and menus, into a computerized voice that is spoken aloud. In short, a screen reader transforms a graphic user interface into an audio interface. Screen readers are most useful for visually impaired computer users. Speech recognition or voice recognition programs. These systems allow people to give commands and enter data using their voices rather than a mouse or keyboard. Voice recognition system use a microphone attached to the computer, which can be used to create text documents such as letters or email messages, browsing the internet, and the navigating among applications and menus by voice. Screen enlargers or screen magnifiers. This system is very useful for the people with low vision. It works like a magnifying glass for the computer by enlarging a portion of the screen, which can increase legibility and make it easier to see items on the computer. Some screen enlargers allow a person to zoom in and out on a particular area of the screen. Braille embossers. With the use of this, students can transfer computer-generated text into embossed Braille output. In this system, Braille translation programs convert text scanned in generated via standard word processing programs into Braille, which can be printed on the embosser. Refreshable Braille displays. Through this software, students are provided with tactile output of information represented on the computer screen. The user read the Braille letters with his or her fingers, and then after a line is read, can refresh the display to read the next line. Text to speech or speech synthesizers. Students, these software receive information going to the screen in the form of letters, numbers, and punctuation marks, and then speak it out loud in a computerized voice. The use of speech synthesizers allows computers users who are visually impaired or who have learning difficulties to hear what they are typing, and also provide a spoken voice for individuals who cannot communicate orally but can communicate their thoughts through typing. Talking and large print word processors. These processors are very useful for the people with low or very poor vision. They are software programs that use speech synthesizers to provide auditory feedback of what is being typed. These are print word processors, allow the user to view everything in large text without added screen enlargement. DAISY, Digital Accessible Information System. This is a technical standard for digital audiobooks, periodicals, and computerized text. DAISY is designed to be a complete audio substitute for print material and is specifically designed for use by people with print disabilities, including blindness, impaired vision, and dyslexia. Based on the MP3 and XML format, the DAISY format has advanced features in addition to those of a traditional audiobook. Users can search, place bookmarks precisely, navigate line by line, and regulate the speaking speed without distortion. Non-Visual Desktop Access, NVDA. This open source software enables visually challenged people to use a computer by communicating what is on the screen using a synthetic voice or braille. It is the only screen reader for Microsoft Windows that is totally free, yet fully functional and portable. Students can download it to their PC or to portable media, such as a USB stick, which they can use with any computer at school, work, etc. Braille slate. A wooden board with holes on either side, metal guide is fitted with these holes and brought down as writing progresses. Each cell in the guide has 6 notches, representing 6 dots in Braille. On the top, there is a clamp with the pins to hold the paper in position. This is the simplest appliance used for writing Braille, interline Braille frame, Taylor postcard frame, pocket Braille frame. These are the 3 forms of Braille slate. Stylus. These are produced with handles of various shapes to suit individual needs. The points of all styli are made of stainless steel and the handles are of polished hardwood or synthetic material. Taylor arithmetic frame and arithmetic and algebra type. The surface of this aluminium frame is divided into star-shaped holes with 8 angles, thus allowing the double-ended metal types to be placed in different positions according to a set system. Abacus, a simple instrument for performing rapid arithmetical calculations. It consists of a frame holding 13 vertically arranged rods on which beads side up and down. The beam supporting the beads is marked with a raised dot at each rod position and a raised bar between every third rod. The bars serve to indicate the decimal point and other units of decimal measure. Braille board. It is a favorable Braille learning tools for kids. It is made of 3 rows and 10 cells and is accompanied by 180 metal pegs to make different words or sentences. Letter cube. A little cube helps the child learn Braille in a very exciting way. It is a 3-sectioned rectangular cube which can be rotated to form any letter. Word forming block. A plastic piece of block to make children learn 5 or 8 letter words. Alphabet trainer plate. It is made up of a plastic plate which has Braille letters embossed and the English letters are engraved. Word building kit. This kit has 60 plastic pieces of alphabets in Braille and in English can be interlocked to form words. Geometry kit. This kit has set of 30 degree and 40 degree set squares, compass scale 30 centimeters, protector and other instruments that can be used for studies. Brailler. It is an upward writing machine for writing on one side of the paper, enabling the Braille to be read as it is written. It has 9 keys, 3 for paper setting and 6 for embossing. The Braille embosses combinations of 6 dots in a Braille cell. The Braille machine is made up of metal with an enamel finish with plastic key tops and adjustable margin stops. The paper is roller fed and line spacing is achieved by pressing a special key. ब्रेल डुप्लिकेटर्स, थर्मोफॉर्म मशीन सेमी ऑटोमेटिक ब्रेल डुप्लिकेटिंग मशीन. इट इज़ यूजफुल फॉर टेकिंग आउट मल्टीपल कॉपीज ऑफ द ब्रेल मैटर ऑन द इंडोथर्म शीट्स फ्रॉम द मास्टर जनरली प्रिपेयर्ड ऑन द ब्रेल पेपर. दिस मशीन ऑपरेट्स ऑन द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वैक्यूम एंड हाई टेम्परेचर. ऑप्टेकॉन रीडिंग मशीन. द ऑप्टेकॉन इज एन इलेक्ट्रोमैकेनिकल डिवाइस दैट एनेबल्स ब्लाइंड यूजर्स टू रीड प्रिंटेड मटेरियल दैट हैज़ नॉट बीन ट्रांसक्राइब्ड इन टू ब्रेल. इट कंसिस्ट ऑफ ए कैमरा लेंस कनेक्टेड टू अ मेन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक यूनिट दैट कंटेन्स ए टेक्टाइल एरे दैट कंसिस्ट ऑफ वाइब्रेटिंग रॉड्स दैट यूजर्स फील विद देयर इंडेक्स फिंगर. प्रिंटेड टेक्स्ट इज एसेंशियली ट्रांसलेटेड इन टू टेक्टाइल वाइब्रेटिंग इमेजेस. कर्ज़वली रीडिंग मशीन. द कर्ज़वल रीडिंग मशीन कन्वर्ट्स प्रिंट टू स्पीच एंड इज डिजाइंड एज ए रीडिंग प्रोस्थेटिक एड फॉर द ब्लाइंड एंड विजुअली हैंडीकैप्ड. द सिस्टम हैंडल्स ऑर्डिनरी प्रिंटेड मटीरियल बुक्स लेटर्स रिपोर्ट्स मेमोरेंडा एट्सेट्रा इन मोस्ट कॉमन स्टाइल्स एंड साइज ऑफ पेपर्स. आउटपुट प्रोड्यूस्ड इज अ सिंथेटिक वॉइस यूजिंग फुल वर्ड इंग्लिश स्पीच. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक ब्रेल नोट टेकर. स्मॉल पोर्टेबल डिवाइसेस विद ब्रेल कीबोर्ड्स फॉर एंट्रिंग इंफॉर्मेशन. दे यूज अ स्पीच सिंथेसाइजर और ब्रेल डिस्प्ले फॉर आउटपुट. ब्रेल डिस्प्ले टेक्नोलॉजी. दीज डिवाइसेस ऑपरेट बाय रेजिंग एंड लोअरिंग डिफरेंट कॉम्बिनेशंस ऑफ पिंस इलेक्ट्रॉनिकली टू प्रोड्यूस इन ब्रेल वॉट अपीयर्स ऑन अ पोर्शन ऑफ द कंप्यूटर स्क्रीन. स्टैंड अलोन स्कैनर्स. दीज आर ऑल इन वन 3D प्रिंटर्स with integrated computer touch screens and 3D scanners. Video magnifiers. Video magnifier or closed circuit television uses a stand mounted or handled video camera to project a magnified images onto a video monitor, a television screen or a computer monitor. Braille printers. After being sent information to be brailled from computer devices, Braille printers do actual embossing of Braille out paper. Actual embossing of Braille onto paper, both one-sided and two-sided Braille printers. Magnification software. There are several magnification software like ZoomText, Magic, Lunar, etc., which help in magnifying content. Screen access software, Cobra, Guide, Jaws, Supernova screen reader, System Access, Talking Toolback, VoiceOver, Window Eye, Pro and few of the screen access software. Braille translation software. Braille 2000, Duxbury Braille Translator, Mega Dots, View Plus Braille Translator, WinBraille, etc. Mobility devices. Those devices which helps or aids an individual to move from one place to another safely, securely, independently and gracefully, such as long cane, folding cane, lesser cane, long cane and folding cane. It is made up of aluminium tubing by 12 mm outer diameter and is 90 centimeter long. It has a grip at the top and a nylon tip at the bottom so that it does not slip. Long cane is used by adults. A variety of cane tips are available. Laser cane. This is an electronic cane that uses invisible laser beams to detect obstacles, drop-offs, and similar hazards in the surroundings. Once the cane detects the obstacle or drop-offs using the laser beams, it will produce a specific audio signal. The cane has three distinct audio signals. Each one indicates a specific distance. The audio signal forms the user of the distance of the obstacles or the height of the drop-off. This device can detect objects and hazards up to the distance of 12 feet. A part of the cane's handle also vibrates and there is an object in front of the user. Electronic travel devices. Laser cane, ultrasonic torch, sonic guide, light probe, mini beeper, Lindsay Russell, E-Model, Pathfinder, etc. are few of the electronic travel devices which are very helpful for the visually challenged. Mobility show card. A plastic show card to help visually impaired persons to cross busy roads and to hail a taxi. Daily living devices for visually impaired. Clocks and watches, games and puzzles, sports, kitchen equipment, personal devices. A script talk station. This device helps to scan and read the small print and look alike packaging of medicine vials. Can lead to confusion, non-compliance and mistakes. Some other free solutions for visually challenged or low vision students. Few of the other free software based solutions for the visually challenged or low vision students include Firefox, CLC, Star, iZoom Web, System Access, Togo, etc. Devices for assisting in receiving and responding. The TLM should be provided in the e-form, digital format. Screen reader for recording aloud, the text format and picture description narration. Audio recording. Basic phone, smartphone, standalone sound recorder, devices for recording the responses in examination hall. The audio message given by the examinees can be captured by a learning management system as it is in audio form, which can be later evaluated by an evaluator. The audio signals can be converted into the digital text by LMS. In addition, the audio responses can be registered and automatically converted into a digital format by detecting the segments given by the candidate in an interactive 3D virtual reality system. Let us conclude. We talk a lot of special education, integrated education, inclusive education of the disadvantaged groups and their sustainable development, but there are wide gaps between our feelings and action. We have anubhuti but not anupranit. Feeling without action for a while is futile. Technology without application is useless. Sustaining every entity in sound health is the concern of education. Same holds true in the case of Dharmesh. Thank you.